Yells.
Yeah, buddy. Johnson8312, the biggest boss on YouTube, bring you guys another 100 plus, this time on the map raid. Yes, of course, the map raid, the map that everyone loves to play and everyone hates to see. I don't know, man, if it's a good map, you know what I mean? That's, of course, where you're going to get your gameplays from, but using that MP7, and I'm not using dogs and swarm, not using the high streaks, using the streaks I was using from the last video, using that VSAT, the escort drone, and the Warthog. So these are lower streaks. They're not, you know, low streaks completely, but they're definitely a lot lower than the streaks that you usually see people get 100 pluses with. So I don't know, switching it up a little bit. But what I want to talk about is Treyarch. This game right here could probably be one of the best first-person shooters ever to be created. And I think that's what frustrates so many people, is I get that nice C4 toss, get that guy in the window, pick this guy up right here. But I think that's what frustrates people so much about Black Ops 2, is that they have literally the tools to make the best first-person shooter probably ever, but they won't fix the certain things that they need to fix. They won't address these things. Target Finder, come on now. How has that not been upon anybody's, you know, bulletin board in the development team's list to patch and, you know, nerf? They've never once said, hey, you know what, we kind of dropped the ball with this Target Finder, let's do something to fix it. I haven't heard anybody from the developers or anybody on Twitter or anything like that say, hey, you know what, let's do something to address this, because people are, you know, complaining about it. The voice of the community, everyone is saying, hey, this needs to be addressed, it's a problem. And the thing is, I mean, as far as nerfing it, it can be done. They can make it where, you know, the red diamonds fade off at a distance, you know what I mean? Or maybe minimize the big rectangle or square that shows up. You know what I mean? There's things that they can do to patch it. I mean, they don't have to take it completely out the game, because if they take it completely out the game, what they do is they admit that they failed. And I think these developers don't want to admit that they failed. And like I said, if they would just address the Target Finder, do some things with this lag, and also take out skill-based matchmaking, as I get that nice three-piece, but take out skill-based matchmaking. It's either you have league play where you want the competitive scene, or skill-based matchmaking, because I died one off of a nuclear. I don't know, man, that guy outplayed me. You know, I was trying to call in my streaks, and I got cleaned up. It is what it is. But if they would just address a few things, this game right here could be the best first-person shooter ever to be created, in my opinion. I mean, this might not be the, you know, popular opinion, but like I said, if they would just address a few things, this game could be perfect. I couldn't see anything wrong with it, because like I said, there isn't really anything like far as imbalancing in the guns, except the SMGs have gotten really weak. And that's another thing too. I feel like out the box, these guns were not 100% balanced, but they were very close to being 100% balanced. And with all the nerfing they've done, they've taken the SMGs and made it probably not the worst. Well, yeah, they're probably the worst the worst class in the game. Probably the shotguns, maybe you can make that argument. But with all the patching they've done, the silencer on the SMGs are just terrible. You know, I'm using a silenced SMG in this game. It might not show it that much in this game, but anything from mid-range, it takes so many bullets to drop people in this game. And especially with the hit detection or the connection issues and these broken cameras that they talk about, that's definitely a big thing. This is a Twitch shooter, and if it's taking me more bullets to drop you than it takes you to drop me, that's a problem. But I don't know. Like I said, I don't want to complain about it. I'm just, like I said, frustrated because they have the tools to make this the best first-person shooter ever to be created. But instead of taking advantage of the tools that they have, they're just ignoring it. It's like, I really wish that they would take advantage of it. As I clean this guy up, I don't know why he was laying on the ground in the back. But like I said, I don't know, man. It is what it is. Not really too much you can complain about, but like I've really said, I really feel like this could be the best first-person shooter ever to be created. But as it stands, it's not a bad game. You get into bad lobbies, you know what I mean? Like, every other game, it's always hit and miss. You never know what you're going to get into when you go into a game. And I just, like I said, I wish they would take skill-based matchmaking out. Make it either league players for the skill-based matchmaking, and make it for the online regular, you know, be regular matchmaking, not skill-based matchmaking. One or the other, because Call of Duty is a 65% connection-based game, 30% luck, and 5% skill. It's not a competitive game. Let's stop that. But thanks for watching, guys. I'm out. Peace.